By the end of this video, you're going to learn how to create Facebook and Instagram carousels without the need of complicated software like Photoshop and without needing to be a graphic designer. If you're new to this channel, my name is Armando, and I help small business owners and entrepreneurs use the internet to generate more leads and make more sales. And if that's something that you're interested in, go ahead and click that subscribe button so that you don't miss out on future training videos. Now, throughout this process, I'm going to walk you through the exact same steps that I use to create all my seamless carousel ads for all of my clients across multiple different industries. These type of carousel ads have helped me and my clients generate thousands of leads and hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of revenue. The very first thing that you have to do is you have to go and use Canva.com. So if you're new to Canva, I put a link in the description that takes you there so you can sign up for a free account. The very first thing that you have to do after you've created your free Canva account is create your actual design layout. So what you want to do is click on create a design, and then from there you want to choose custom dimensions. Now, a carousel is a square image that is 1080 by 1080. So for the height, you have to put in 1080, and that's actually going to give you the max height that you can create a carousel in. For the width, it's going to depend on how many tiles you want. For example, a Facebook ad has up to 10 tiles. So you can create up to 10 individual carousels for a Facebook ad. I believe Instagram is the same, but don't quote me on that. Now, let's say that you just wanted to create 3 tiles, then you would just multiply 1080 by 3. If you wanted to create 10, then your dimensions would be 1080 by 10. In the case of this example, I'm going to be creating a carousel that has 4 tiles, so 4 different cards. So I would just multiply 1080 by 4, and that gives me a total of 4320. I'm going to click on create design, and that's going to give us our black canvas that we'll then create our carousel from. Step number 2 is to actually go and click on file, and we want to add show rulers, and then you also want to say show grid lines. That way we can divide this into even squares based on our design. Step number 3 is to actually start to add your creative in here. Now, for the sake of this training, I'm going to just pick one of these pre-designed creatives that we have here, but it's good to explain that you can actually add whatever you want. You can design this any way you want. So if you have images that you've uploaded to this, you can add your images in here. If you have text or a specific graphic that you want to split in a carousel, you can add that in here as well. So I'm just going to pick one of these. So now that you have your design laid out here, the very next step that you have to do is actually split this. And in order to do this, we want to right click anywhere on the canvas, and we want to add a vertical grid line. That's going to give us a grid line that looks something like this. Now, what you have to do here, this ruler here that we added in the very beginning is pixels. It sizes in pixels. So you want to adjust this to 1080 by 1080. On each square. And then what you want to do is just right click again, and you want to add an additional vertical grid line, and that's going to be the other 1080. So what you can do here, what's neat about this is that if you create a canvas that, let's say, is 5 cards, you can actually snap this to the next grid point in time. So if you actually multiply 1080 by 2, you get 2160. So now that you've added the grid lines, you have 4 squares, which is 4 different carousels that you're going to be splitting up. And you can see that this layout is a little bit fluid, where some of it comes across from one card to the next. And that's exactly what we want. For this tutorial, I'm just going to move this design, this element here in the middle, so you can kind of see how it splits things up. And I'm going to be moving this little guy. Actually, we'll leave that little guy alone, and I'm gonna move this thing over here so you can kind of see that each one of these carousel ads, or each one of these carousels, will blend into the next one. So I'm going to clone this entire element here. Actually, I'm going to add a few more elements in here just so that we can give this a different look. So now, once you're finished with your design layout, the way it's going to look, each one of these cards will basically cut off right here in the middle where this grid line is, and the next card will begin. And so the next step that you want to do is just kind of give this a name. I'm going to say demo here. And what you want to do here is download this. Now, unfortunately, Canva doesn't allow you to split this, so we have to download it and then re-upload it in order to make this work. So make sure you click on the download button. And if you want transparent background, that's totally up to you. Click on download, and that's going to download this file for you. The next step that we have to do is create the actual carousel in each individual card. So this is what the full layout will be like when you're scrolling through Instagram or through Facebook. But now we want to chop this up into individual cards that are sequential so that they work across each platform. In order to do that, you're going to go back home on Canva. Then you're going to click on Create Design, then go to Instagram Post. From here, what you want to do is just take the image that you just downloaded and drag it onto the new canvas. And you want to stretch this out. Now, you don't want to make this part of the background because then it's going to crop things off and it's going to look weird. What you want to do is adjust it from the corners so that each corner, each time you pull, it pulls the entire graphic evenly. So I'll show you what happens here. So if you want to drag and drop this image this way. Now, it may look a little odd on my screen just simply because I'm on a huge Mac, and so therefore the size of the screen is different, but yours might not look, you know, like this. So once we have this, you know, we just want to make sure that it snaps in place on the bottom and the top, and you should be able to see the guides there. And then what you want to do is just adjust the very first one here, just like that. Then what you want to do is come here and clone this card, duplicate that, then take this and realign this, slide it to where the next step is going to be in the process. And what you're going to notice in here is that it snaps for you. So if you go really slow, you'll see that it's going to snap right there. Maybe you didn't see that, and I'm going to, you know, kind of go slow a little bit. But if you focus on the right hand corner of the screen, where this point meets, or where this point meets on the left, you'll notice that there is a slight snap. There you go. And Canva will actually adjust where your grid lines are for the next card based on the previous layout that you did. So we're going to complete the next step by just repeating what we just did. We're going to clone this card, and then we're going to take this and adjust that all the way to the left and make sure that you feel the snap, or you see the snap of where the card is going to be there. There you go. And we're going to do that one more time. And this time it's going to go all the way to where we need that to be. And that's what it's going to look like. So now you have four cards, card one, card two, card three, card four. And what you want to do now is just download this. We're going to say carousel demo one. I'm going to download this from Canva. Now, what I'm going to do now is upload these to a post on Facebook so you can see exactly what this is going to look like once you upload your design. Now, while I go ahead and do this, now would be a good time to hit that subscribe button so that you don't miss out on future videos. Okay, I went ahead and added these into a mock-up design so that you can get an idea. You can see what it's going to look like. You can see that it actually works across multiple devices. So this is what it's going to look like on Instagram. If you follow the directions in this video, you can see that this is card number one. That's card number two, that's card number three, and then that's card number four. You can see that it's all seamless. And then this is what it's going to look like on Facebook. So this is what the mobile feed will look like. And then this is what the desktop feed is going to look like for your carousel design. Now, there are a few more things to consider when you create a seamless carousel ad. And number one is the number of tiles or cards that you're going to have. Make sure that you know ahead of time how many cards, how many tiles you're going to have, because if you want to go back and then add more tiles, it becomes a little bit more complicated based on your design. Number two, make sure that you know which platform you're designing for. In my case, I always design for both Facebook and Instagram because we run ads for both Facebook and Instagram. But you may just be designing for one or the other. Make sure you keep that in mind. Make sure that your dimensions are correct. 1080 by 1080 is the size of a square carousel for both Facebook and Instagram. Now, if for whatever reason you're having any trouble and you need help with this process, leave me a comment below and I'll try to respond back to you as best as I can. If this was super helpful, please consider giving it a thumbs up, consider subscribing. And if you are a small business owner, if you own a brick and mortar or local service-based business, and you've probably been at a point where you've created Facebook ads and you just get a bunch of likes and a bunch of clicks and a bunch of shares, but not enough leads or jobs, then I created a workshop just for you. You can check it out with the link in the description. It's very straight to the point, nothing fluffy. You can go through it in an hour, in a couple hours if you wanted to, and it shows you exactly how to use Facebook lead ads to start to generate leads within a week. And if that's something that you're interested in, go ahead and click the link in the description as well. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next one.